Say every arrow of laziness and weariness in my body, jump out as I shake my body now. In the name of Jesus, every arrow of laziness and weariness in my body, jump out as I shake my body now. In the name of Jesus, shake your body wherever you are. Let every arrow of laziness and weariness in your body jump out now. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Children of God, many Christians are practicing prayerlessness. So we are prayerless Christians. Many don't have time to fellowship with God. No quiet time. No time to pray. No time to worship the King of Kings. There is no time to give thanks, to appreciate the love of God. Wherever we are, we need to change our mindset. If you are a prayerless Christian, let's start from the beginning in the Bible. When we open to the book of Genesis chapter 3 verse 9. Book of Genesis chapter 3 verse 9. And the Lord God called unto Adam and said unto him, where art thou? Children of God, God asked Adam the same question when he hid from the Lord in the Garden of Eden. Adam, where art thou? The Lord knew where Adam was all along. He really was asking Adam, why has he rejected fellowship and showing him that there was danger in hiding from his presence? Prayerless Christian don't realize what danger they are in. You may object, so what if some Christians don't pray? They are still believers, blood cleansed, forgiven, and going to heaven. Where is the danger in growing a little lukewarmness? Wherever you are, God knows your works. Today you are hot, tomorrow you are cold. Let's open our Bible to the book of Revelation chapter 3, reading from verse 15 to 16. Book of Revelation chapter 3. From verse 15 to 16, I know thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot. I will thou wert cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will pour thee out of my mouth. This is the word of God to the prayerless Christian. God said he will pour them out of his mouth. Children of God, I believe our Heavenly Father realized we live in a busy age with many demands on our time and energy. And Christians are caught up in busyness and activities as much as anyone else. Yet I cannot believe God take lightly our rejection of his access, which cost his only begotten son life, Jesus Christ, on the cross of Calvary. God has made Christ our strong tower. That's why the Bible said in the book of Proverbs chapter 18 verse 10. Book of Proverbs chapter 18 verse 10. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is saved. But only those who run into it are saved, brethren. If you don't go in, then you are still outside the door. You stand where Israel stood, but God does not meet anyone at the door anymore. Children of God, all the provision we need is inside. Forgiveness of sin, mercy in time of need, power to overcome, power to conquer the enemy. The fire of revival is inside. Children of God, imagine the pain of rejection felt by God and His Son Jesus Christ. I envision this conversation taking place between God and Jesus Christ, saying, "Son, you were beaten, mocked, crucified, and buried. It so pained me. I shut my eyes at the sight. Yet you fulfilled the everlasting covenant. You provided acceptance and access for all who will trust in you. Because of you, a last day people will be able to come to me, and they will grow mightily in my strength, building reserve of faith against a devil who will tempt and try them as at no other time. Yet, where our beloved children, Monday passes and we never see them. Tuesday arrive, all see no children. Wednesday comes with no sight of them. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday pass. Yes, still we don't see them. Only on Sunday do they approach us. Sunday medicine. Why they are in church? Why don't they come? Don't they love us? This is the conversation between God and Jesus. I envision this conversation between the Father and the Son. We need to change our way. Many have neglected prayer. They don't have time for the worship of God. They don't have time to fellowship with their Maker. Children of God, indeed, Christians who don't appropriate access to the Father end up in a saddest condition. Brethren, it is important. Do not joke with your prayer life. When you are playing with your prayer life, there is danger. You want to give access to the wicked powers of this world to enter your life. The Lord instructed John in the book of Revelation chapter 3 verse 1 that unto the angels of the church in Sardis write these things, said he that has the seven spirits of God and the seven star, I know thy works, that thou hast a name, that thou livest and are dead. If you have been playing or joking with your prayer life, the high time has come. We need to come back now. The Bible says, pray without ceasing. Wherever we are, don't joke with your prayer day and night. Also at midnight, it is necessary and important. I pray that the Lord God will open our understanding in the name of Jesus. Peradventure, you are listening under the sound of my voice and you have not given your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. This is a great opportunity for you to accept Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior. Tomorrow might be too late. I want you to lay your right hand on your chest and you will say after me. If you have made up your mind that you want to give your life to the Lord Jesus, say, Father, I come before you now. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. As from today, I say bye-bye to the devil. I enter into the kingdom of light. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I congratulate us. We have made the right choice of our life. Let us open our mouth and begin to confess now. Say, Father, forgive me every known and unknown sin. Father, forgive me, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Father, forgive me. Have mercy upon my life in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, have mercy, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you because you are God. We give you glory, we give you honor and adoration. Blessed be your holy name in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the life of those that accepted Jesus into their life. Accept them, O Lord, in Jesus' name. Father, forgive them, O Lord, every known and unknown sin in their life in the name of Jesus. Have mercy upon their life. By your mercy, O Lord, baptize them with your Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your holy name. For in Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Let's also open our mouth and begin to worship the Lord. Worship the King of Kings. You can open your mouth and sing now to appreciate the love of God upon your life. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus. Heavenly Father, we worship you, Lord. In Jesus' wonderful name, we worship. Amen. You will shout loud and clear. Say, every spirit of discouragement in my life, die in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of discouragement in my life, die in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of discouragement in prayer in my life, die now in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of discouragement in prayer in my life, die in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Say, oh God, arise and plug my life to the socket of your fire and power in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise and plug my life to the socket of your fire and power in the name of Jesus. Oh God, arise and plug my life to the socket of your fire and power in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Say, my prayer altar and prayer life, receive fresh fire and anointing in the name of Jesus. My prayer altar and prayer life, receive fresh fire and anointing in the name of Jesus. My prayer altar and prayer life, receive fresh fire and anointing in the name of Jesus. Receive it now in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' wonderful name we pray. Amen. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the key. Prayer is the master key. Jesus started with prayer and ended with prayer. Prayer is the master key. Father, in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we thank you because you are the Lord. Glory be to your holy name in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, accept our thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, your children has cried loud unto thee. Father, forgive all sins in the name of Jesus. Have mercy, O Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, arise, O Lord. Rekindle your fire in the life of your children in the name of Jesus. Fresh fire from above. Father, release it upon our life in the name of Jesus. I pray for you wherever you are. Every arrow of laziness and weariness in prayer that is operating in your body shall go back to the sender in the name of Jesus. Receive fresh fire in the name of Jesus. The God that answered by fire shall over answer you by fire in the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, in the name of God the Holy Spirit. Anytime you go down your knees, anytime you call on God, God shall recognize your voice for divine response and over-answer you. In the name of Jesus, so shall it be. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. Let's share the grace in fellowship. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.